Back here in the Mid-South, Memphis gets a visit from an international dignitary.
We are so happy to welcome Czech Republic Ambassador to the U.S. Hynek Kmonicek is visiting Memphis as a part of Memphis in May, and I hope I didn't start an international incident with your name.
Never, because we are used to have completely unpronounceable names.
So this is common.
Actually, you almost qualified as a Czech now because you got it right.
We feel better now.
I get like diplomatic privileges or something to come visit, which I would love to do. What do you most hope that Memphians learn about the Czech Republic while you're here?
Well, we do hope that because we are the focus country of this year's festival, that it will like provoke them a little bit to learn a little bit more about our existence.
Yeah.
Because we used to be called Czechoslovakia,
right.
And for many people, we are the country somewhere in the Eastern Europe.
That whole region kind of confuses us, right?
Well, it's part of the problem. We are not Eastern Europe.
Yeah, right.
We are west of Vienna. And Austrian Vienna is in the west, so if you are west of the west, it's very hard to end up in the east. And what we would like basically to bring to Memphians is that if they are thinking where to go next year for the family vacation, there is a 10 million country, which is like the safest, sixth safest place on this planet.
And very clean and beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And so small that if you take a car from our capital in any direction, in 2 hours you are abroad.
Mm. Wow.
And still in this area you can find, let's say, more castles than France has.
You have, what, about 2,000 castles there, or roughly how many?
I would say that last time we counted like 927, but we are not sure because we have that many that we don't know what to count, actually. Every small village has one.
And who do families still, are some of them family owned still?
Some of them are like the culture sites. Some of them are in the hands of the original families. This country was for 1,000 years basically on the way from Germany to Russia,
right? Mm-hmm.
Which means that everybody loved it. Everybody occupied it, and because everybody occupied it, nobody destroyed it because he wanted to live there.
Well, that's a
very interesting way to put it.
So you go around and you can see like 800 years of architecture under 2 minutes of your walk.
Wow.
We recently had some Memphis students here on this show, Live at 9, and they were essentially bragging about their visit there. What do you personally find so fascinating?
That it is very cozy place to live, very multicultural, where you simply find the things, exactly the ones you do not expect. Mm-hmm. You expect the Eastern European country, which in the mental image will be something with a little bit lower life standard than the Americans has, and some problems. What you find there is actually something like the mini Switzerland, where we have 14 national minorities living there, including Vietnamese, who are the third biggest national minority there, or Mongolians. Like 10% of Mongolians on this planet speak our totally improbable language.
Well, speaking of language.
And you know, we really developed in the 19th century because we really needed to be sure which one of us Czechs is actually a German. So who never learned it was proclaimed German.
You speak five or six languages, right? Do most Czechs speak English, you know, so the Americans are afraid that nobody will understand us because we don't learn any other languages.
Of course, and we are used to it, so with the younger generation, English is so widely spoken that in Prague, in capital, actually, you don't need Czech language practically at all. It will be different if you go 20 miles out of Prague, then you will find us locals speaking the horrible language nobody understands, and that's exactly how
we
like it.
Lots of Z's and K's, right?
On a more serious note, though, Ambassador, you have been an ambassador to so many different countries as well. What do you think the Czech Republic's perception of the U.S. is today? Brand new president in office. How do you view us these days?
Well, we view the United States as a country which is constantly changing. Like every 20 years, we are dealing with a different United States.
Mm-hmm.
Are sort of mentally preparing ourselves for the next 20 years, where we expect that like the 40% of your voters will be Latinos.
Yeah.
So we can more or less expect who will be the next presidents.
Mm. Right.
And these next presidents will have zero European background. And that's something what we must take into account. Because we are really interested in having Americans in Europe. Yeah. You are part of our safety structure.
Right.
It's very hard to imagine any safety structure, where a security structure where you wouldn't be involved, given the strength of the United States.
Sure.
But at the same time, we want you to understand who we are.
Right.
And that's why the Czech Republic is the one who tries to bring a lot of people here. Last number, 10 million country had last year 31 million tourists.
Well, we are going to have to come visit, especially since we got your name right.
Thank you
very much. Diplomatic privilege.
Thank you. Thank you very
much.
Enjoy your stay.
For sure.
And good morning, Memphis. Remember to come to visit us.